Yo, screaming. We really mellowed it out.
Every episode, we give a band the lyrics to a song they've never heard before, and they have just 1 hour to write and record their own original version. This is Blind Covers.
Hi, welcome to Blind Covers, the only music show on the internet. Don't look it up. I'm here with my new friend, Cuee.
Hey, What's up? How are you?
What was the first album you bought with your own money?
Beyonce's Lemonade. And I know that is crazy, but I was streaming a lot. And then YouTube was my thing. So like, you wouldn't find me on iTunes buying music. Like, I had a lot of CDs, but my dad's a DJ. So like, I would just get stuff from him.
So was your dad responsible for shaping your music taste?
Definitely.
Do you still share a lot of music taste?
Absolutely. Yeah, when I just went home, I discovered that he is now a new fan of Nipsey Hussle. And he's like blasting Nipsey, and I'm like, wow, I'm listening to this too. And he's like, man, I wish I would have picked him up earlier, you know? And I was like, me too. So that was like, taste of music is still kind of there.
Is there an artist that you started modeling yourself after when you started making music?
Yeah, definitely. It was Chance the Rapper, actually, when I started seeing him. I was working at the radio station on campus. I went to a show on Mass Street. And I've always like listened to him in high school a little bit, like, but seeing him live and then knowing what he was about, I started modeling myself after Chance a lot. You learn that after a while, after you start to find your voice, you're like, okay, I like you a lot, but we're not the same person.
So what was that process like starting to develop your own voice?
After Shameless, my last tape, it was when I kind of started stepping out of the box. I was so gung-ho on what people were thinking. Even some of the stuff that I was talking about, just coming into myself, coming more out the closet, and everybody was receiving it and loving it, and I was like, whoa, this is me. You always know what you wanted to say, so just say it and just do it.
Yeah.
You don't have to look after any other person to do this.
What is a lyric you hate in a song you love?
From the artist I love, Chance the Rapper, favorite song is the name of the song. And in there he says, he will slap a faggot. I'm like, wow, Chance, like, out of all your lyrics in the world, that's what you can rhyme with that.
Yeah.
I've got one more question for you. Are you ready to find out what song you're gonna cover?
I am. I've been thinking about this for...
All right, let's find out.
We're taking all of this, recreating this.
Yes.
Let's go.
Yeah. All right, cool.
Y'all, we got a long song. Come on. Wasting time.
Ooh, yeah, ooh, I don't care. Ah.
Has everyone read everything?
Nope.
I'm reading right now. There's a lot of pain and shame.
It's pain, right. I want to know how y'all feel like, reading these lyrics. Like,
I'm uncomfortable.
Perfect crime, lost in time. I give you all this up chance to find my way back to summer in 2003 when I felt alive. You know? This is kind of like bars in a sense. I like this. Like,
you just got to figure out how to...
Yeah, you just got to figure out how to structure it.
Dang, he want to fill up the whole place with gasoline.
This is like Eminem.
Yeah, because
I don't care. Hurting.
This is like some Eminem type shit. Eminem does get this graphic. Yeah.
Okay, so there is a hook. It's the...
Wasting time.
Wasting time. All along, you're just wasting time.
They also repeat the, well, I can see you're waiting, but I don't care part. That could be like our hook through the main part, and then for the outro, we do the wasting time.
That's cool.
Do we want this to be like one of those songs that's got real dark lyrics, but has like a happy, like...
Yeah.
That's what I was just saying, like Juice WRLD. Juice WRLD, do say some depressing shit on some very fire-ass beat.
Yeah.
I'm keeping that in my head.
Like, I'm kind of getting the vibes of what's the Action Bronson and Chance song?
It sounded like Black Eyed Peas a little. Yeah.
Do you like that kind of happy thing, or do we want to go that direction? We don't have to.
I kind of like that. Go back, go do that one
more
time.
You want us to keep playing through it?
Yeah, because I'm nervous. So, when we say we can take some lyrics, this line says to fill this whole place up with gasoline. So, in other words, can I say, blow this bitch up?
Yeah. Cool. How much you got so far? Wasting time all along, you've been wasting mine. Draw the line all this time, we just drawing mine. Only problem I see is no end in sight. Ooh.
Mm. Oh, yeah, let's hit that in there.
I can see you waiting, but I don't care.
Boy, don't get me excited.
You know, like Uzi be adding some pauses.
Q, do you want these chords to go through the whole song, or do you want there to be some kind of transitionary point?
I always kind of like the thing where
find the lyrics that you think are like the crucial part of this and make that kind of like, I guess, a bridge or something.
Yeah, let's do that.
Do you want us to look angry or happy?
You know, that's real.
That's a good fucking question.
Do you have the ability to look angry?
We're learning a dance for the song.
We got 6 minutes. Let's not let Owen lead the dance at all. Owen adds personality.
The thing that people don't realize is Owen is the only thing holding anything together.
Yeah, he has smiles on everyone's faces, so.
Just like literally just draw a little thing and say this is verse one. That's all I need. What if we like hear the real version of this and it's like.
That's what I'm saying. I think it's gonna be some like screamo prog rock type shit.
It's like, I feel like this is one of those. This song's kind of like a big fuck you to something.
Oh yeah. You're talking about gasoline and blowing shit up.
Do you want to use that "Cause I Don't Care" thing as like an outro?
Okay.
Yeah. First time I didn't fall asleep till the sun came up, cause we never knew we had enough. It was the first time that we could feel the rush in the streets. Feeling it.
You got it. I don't know.
Keep hyping that up though, cause like that's the end.
Yeah, you know what I mean?
So just like keep.
But it just ends so abrupt. It's just like bam. You're like, damn, it's over.
Yeah, but you know what? In between what we're doing, you could re-wrap these. So like while we're doing, cause Ben's gonna do, wait, do the "Cause I Don't Care." And I'm gonna go, wasting time. Long you're wasting mine. And you could keep going with this.
Cause we never had enough. It was the first time we could feel the rush in the streets, feeling no defeat. Cause when we almost hit that hole.
Bro, you were killing
it. That was so dope.
Yeah, that shit was dope.
Yeah, okay.
That was dope. That worked.
Yeah, it did. I just gotta finish that. It's just odd. It's just an odd number.
No, I feel that. That's what I'm saying. Break it up. Break it up. Just find a way to end it. The best I got.
It's the realest answer though.
I know, it's like, just do it.
You know, I don't care how you do it, just fucking find a way to do it.
So come on, y'all, we gotta get this.
All right, ready?
Live performance.
Yeah, you're starting.
Q. Oh, snaps, not me. Wasting time, Q, Glass Bandits.
Wasting time, all along you're wasting mine. Ignoring all of the signs.
waste of time. Cause I don't care.
Whew. That was something.
Best hour spent of my life.
All right.
We got a lot done in an hour.
Yeah.
So it was good.
What do you think that song is about?
Someone's going through some sort of heartbreak or something. And they're not taking it too well. They want to blow some stuff up.
What's your best guess as to what kind of song this is?
I feel like it's a rock song. I don't know.
Yeah.
Yeah, like a nice punk rock. The way the lyrics were structured, you know, the rhyme scheme, something like that. Especially with the end and the three hooks, it just kept going and going and going. So.
Well, let's find out if you're right.
Listening. Okay. We really mellowed it out. Screaming, yes. It sounds like an intro to like a high school movie.
What's the plot of this high school movie?
The girl's on a cheerleader team. She meets this guy who's obsessive a little bit. They fall in this little puppy love. Yeah, and then they like break up or something. And
then he burns her house down.
Yeah, because he's a little crazy, but yeah. We don't find that part out till.
Okay.
I'm starting to enjoy it a little bit now. It's been playing in my ear for a second. Yeah. So.
You can see yourself listening to this.
No, probably not. It's just not my style. But
no, it's intense. Yeah.
It was a lot of emotion, passion through the song.
Yeah.
That's what I'm
very
call it.
Passionate. Mm-hmm.
I probably would have never heard this song a day in my life, but thank you. Yeah.
I think you put it best when you said you mellowed it way out. If you had to say something to For You're Strong.
Was everything okay? Like,
we're worried about you guys. We want to make sure you're feeling all right.
So I want to thank them, though, for being able to put all of that into some lyrics, because somebody needed to hear that and feel that, you know? Yeah. So.
What a great positive way to end.
Nice meeting you, Mitch, man.
Nice meeting you.
All right.
Bye.